Hello guys, this video we are going to talk about scaffolding SQL database with DB or database first migration in web API using Entity Framework Core, that is the .NET EF7. So as I speak, the current framework that we're going to use is the EF7, that is the Entity Framework 7. Now, when you talk about scaffold, what does it mean? Let's say you have your database already. Now, you want to create an application and you have your database already. Your database has been populated with tables and data. Now, if you're about to create or if you have to create a new database or new tables, you're going to scrap the table that you have in the database already and you have to start afresh. But thanks to Entity Framework, now with EFCore, we can scaffold the database that we have already and now extract the tables and use them as models or classes in application. So we need not to create a new database again. The old one that we have, we can use that and generate models out of it. So this tutorial is going to help you understand and know how to use it in terms of scaffolding database to models. I have a project, and that is web API project. Before we get to that, I have a database here. Now you can see the name of the database here is Scaffold-DB. Now if I run this query to get the list of the data in that table, because you have the sample data here. We have only one table for now, and these are the various columns. So ID, name, and age. So if I want to scaffold this database and convert these names, these column names as model, is it possible? Yes, it is. And we're going to have a look at it. So the next thing to do here is we are going to create a new project, that's a web API project. If you don't know how to create a web API project, click on File, New, then go to Project. Now with this new project, you're going to search for ASP.NET Core Web API. Click on Next, give it a name, click on Next. So here's the location, and that's the framework. So .NET 7.0, that is the current one as I record this video. Click on Create to get it created. Once you are done, that is the first stage. The next step is to install this Entity Framework packages. Now, these packages are what you are going to use to get the models from the database table. So, right-click on your dependencies in your Solution Explorer. Then go to Manage NuGet Packages. Now, under Browse tab, try to install these packages. I have downloaded them already, so I need not to download them anymore, but I'm going to show you. You type in the name over under the browse tab, then you can download them. The first one that you have to download is a Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore. So that is it. You pass in this name, Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore. Then the current one is 7.0.2. You install that. When you're done, I want you guys to install this. That is a .SQLServer, Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore.SQLServer. Install this as well. And the last one is Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore.Tools. So install this. So you have to install three packages for this to be able to work. Now, when you are done, the next stage is to perform migration. Now with that migration, that is where we are going to perform the scaffold. We're going to scaffold the database and convert the database table columns into models. Where will you do it, or how can you do that? Click on Tools and now go to NuGet Package Manager and Package Manager Console. Now that is your console. Okay, so in here you can see we have our project here. Now if you type in dir for directory, you can see you have the current directory as you are, and that is over here. So let's copy this and get into that directory. So dir, now you want to change to cd, then let's paste this. When you pass in dir again, you can see you are in the list. So the for that, this is your project. Now let's create our database, or let's scaffold the database into models. Now we pass in the scaffold, so we type in scaffold. Now this scaffold then does db context. Whoa, not bd, it's supposed to be db context instead. Yes. Now when you're done, you need to specify connection string. So first one is a server, and that is equal to, you know, I'm using local host, so that's a local server. So I can pass in local server, but in case you're using a database external, then you can pass in. If not, if you've installed the database on your the same computer, then pass in local, and this is going to be located to the local host, or that is the local server or the database server that you have on your computer. Now the next thing to do here is we can specify initial catalog or database. So either you pass in initial catalog, so catalog, okay, this, or you can pass in database. Anyone that you want to do, you can pass in that. So you can pass in database or initial catalog. So this initial catalog is equal to, now what's the name of our database? So let's go to our studio and check. So our database name here, it is scaffold db. So let's copy this, scaffold db. So that's our database name. You close that. The next thing to do here is you have to specify trusted underscore connection. You have to trust the connection, and we set this to true. When we are done, the next thing, you have to trust the server. So trust server certificate, you have to set also to true. Now that we are done, we go back to the end of this double quote. Now we specify our service provider, and with this, since you're using an EF core, our service provider is Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore.SqlServer. So you specify Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore. Then we can add the core, EntityFrameworkCore.SQL, then pass in server. So now we are done. The last thing to do here is, you see, when you create a model, maybe you like to give it a folder and name it as models, isn't it? So let's do the same here, and that is a dash. So you can pass off as output. So this output, passing output directory, then the name of the folder that you want to create is models. Okay, and now here let's pass in this false keyword to force it. In case there's anything, it must still force it and get it done. Now that we are done, let's click on OK, and now let's see what's going to happen here. So we wait while it checks. Now it is saying that scaffold db term is not recognized as a name function. So let's check. So you can see the scaffold was spelled wrongly. So SCA supposed to be no L, but I brought it. So I know you corrected that. So yeah, and I'm going to go back, and now let's see again. So you can see we have build started. So we wait, it's going to generate our model at a context file. That's the application db context file as well. So you can see build succeeded. Now let's wait for the output, and a new folder as models is going to be created over here for us. So we wait and see what's going to happen here. So it is saying that unable to provide assembly, that's a Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore.SQL. Watch here, even the server was spelled correct wrongly. Wow. So let's see server. Okay, now everything is intact. Let's get it again. So build succeeded. And now you go. So keyword not support. So trusted connection. It's supposed to be underscore. Whoa, there are a lot of errors in work now. So supposed to be underscore like this. And let's try this again. Okay, so it is almost done. Now let's wait for the completion, then we know what to do. Okay, so you can see our new database has now been created. Now that is our new model, and this application DbContext, so we can comment this. That is our connection over here. So options builder.use SQL server, and I can see we have initial cata. This is what we specified in there, and that is our connection. We have a database. The table name is what? Employees. When we check a database, because we have employees table, and that is it. And the name that is used here is what? Employees. So let's see in the database. We have, let's refresh this database and see what we have. So let's refresh that table, refresh this. Now you see we have DBO employee table. Okay. And let's check here. We have employee model with the table. Now, when you go to the employee model, you could see from here we have three columns. Let's see if we're going to have the same thing. So go to Solution Explorer. Now, because you have your models folder as you specified. Now, this is the employee.cs. So open that. And you could see we have ID, name, and age. And that is what we specified in there. We have our connection here, as it specified as our connection. So in order to test this, let's try to get the data from this this table by creating using a controller. So let's first add this connection. Let's register this connection in our program.cs file. So we can actually copy this DbContext. Now Solution Explorer, click on program.cs, and now let's add. So builder dot services and now dot add db contest. So we specify that, and that is it. So we have added our connection. So the next thing to do here is let's create our controller to get the data for us. So right click on controllers folder and now click on add new controller. Now this new controller will go for an API empty one, and since it is an employee, we can name this as employee. So employees controller, click on add, and then we have this. Now let's add, let's create a constructor of this control plus period as a dot. Now generate constructor. And now in here, let's paste our contest. Then you can name it as AppDbContext. So AppDbContext. So that's our connection string, our connection file. So control plus period. Let's create an assigned field, period. Now create an assigned field. All right, now we are done. We can specify our first method, and that's an HTTP GET. And now with this get, we want to specify public, and this is going to be an task and action result. Let's set action result. This must get us the list of employee, that is a model. You close it and now get employees. So we open this and now we call for server employees. So employees is equal to, now you can call this await keyword. Since it's a task, we have to await it, and you can see it automatically added this async method. So appdb dot, now you can get the employees table dot to list, then we can go in for to list async. So to convert them to a list, then return. So you can return okay, which return a status code of 200. So okay, then we pass in the employees. So let's see. This is having a problem here. So let's see. You pass in this employees, and that's how you are done. Okay, let's save this, and now let's check our application. Let's run that. Now when you run it, we must have the method which is get employees. So if I click on this, let's see if you're going to have the employees being specified from the list. Now take note that in our list we have this 10 employees here. So let's try that again. So execute. Now let's see if we can get the list of this employee. When we're able to do it, meaning we're able to finish all, the scaffold DB was successfully executed and everything is okay. Now as you can see from here, exactly we have the same thing. So you can see we have the name, that is Fred. Now we have the age, name and age, and that is the ID. So you can see we have it up to 10. And you can see this, we did not create our database here. We made a scaffold to convert the database that we have previously as models being specified here. And we use that model to generate this. So our models, employee models, these are the properties that we have. We use that, and we also had a connection generated, the one that we specified in the console, to get the database and its columns. We have that over here as well. I believe this is simple and it is clear as well. Thank you guys for watching this video, and hopefully I'm going to catch you up in the next video.